My dear brothers, the thing from a person's life which is most apparent in society is a person's character. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam himself, he stated that one of his main missions was to perfect characters of a people. إِنَّمَا بُوِثْتُ لِأُتَمِّمَ مَكَارِمَ الْأَخْلَاقِ. And Allah himself has sworn to the nobility and goodness of the noble conduct and character of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Noon wal qalami wa ma yasturun ma anta bi ni'mati rabbika bi majnun wa inna laka la ajran ghayra mamnun wa innaka la ala khuluqin azim. Right from the beginning, Allah spoke about the noble character of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When Allah blessed Rasulullah with the revelation at the age of 40, Hazrat Al-Amasa was making reference to that as well, and Rasulullah came home. The one who knows a man the best is a person's wife. No one can analyze and describe a person's true personality better than one's wife. Hazrat Khadija radiallahu anha, she summarized the Prophet's noble personality in five very simple phrases. Imam Bukhari has reported them in his Sahih. When Rasulullah came, he was under a state of shock and very anxious, and he said, "Zammiluni, dassiruni." Hazrat Khadija radiallahu anha, she comforted Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam by saying, "You are such a noble man. Allah will not let you go wasted. Innaka latasilur rahim wa tahmilul kal wa taksibul ma'dum wa tuqri'ud dayf wa tu'inu ala nawa'ibil haqq." Hazrat Khadija summarized Rasulullah's personality in five phrases. You enjoin kinship. You carry the burden of those who can't carry their own burden. You help those in severe need. You honor guests and you assist in matters of truth and piety and goodness and haqq. There was nobody else there. There was no witness to the analysis of Hazrat Khadija of Rasulullah's noble personality. These were traits and these were characteristics that not only that Khadija was aware of, but everybody around was aware of from the character of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But the way and in the manner that Hazrat Khadija summarized the Prophet's noble character, there wasn't any person there. The fact that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam joins kinship, the fact that he helps those in desperation, He carries the burden of those who can't carry their own burdens. He honors guests and he assists and stands up for matters of truth. Many years later, when Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, when he could not bear the suffering in Makkah anymore and opposition, and decided it was enough, and he decided to leave Makkah. He was going, and en route he met a famous Arab leader. And he asked, and he knew Hazrat Abu Bakr, and he asked him, "Abu Bakr, where are you going?" He said, "My people won't leave me to worship my Lord in peace. So I am going somewhere where I can worship my Lord in peace." Ibn Daghina, Imam Bukhari rahmahullah, has described and quoted Ibn Daghina, a famous Arab leader, his analysis of Abu Bakr's personality many years long after Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam had started receiving a revelation, and Hazrat Khadija had analyzed and summarized his personality. Ibn Daghina had no idea of the conversation which had occurred between Rasulullah and Hazrat Khadija. But when he saw Abu Bakr leaving Makkah and going in search of peace where he can spend the rest of his life in the worship of Allah, Ibn Daghina said to Hazrat Abu Bakr, "Abu Bakr, a man like you, la yakhruj wa la yukhraj. He shouldn't leave. He shouldn't need to be made to leave." And then the phrases that he spoke in favor of Abu Bakr are exactly the same phrases that Hazrat Khadija had spoken in personality of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Not a word here and there. The only difference is he changed the order. Hazrat Khadija had said, "Innaka latasilur rahim wa tahmilul kal wa taksibul ma'dum wa tukhri'ud dayf wa tu'inu ala nawa'ibil haqq." And Ibn Daghina said, "Abu Bakr, taksibul ma'dum, innaka latasilur rahim wa tahmilul kal wa tukhri'ud dayf wa tu'inu ala nawa'ibil haqq." Abu Bakr, you are such a man. You help those in severe need. And you enjoin kinship. You carry the burden of those who can't carry their own burden. You honor your guests. And you also assist in matters of piety and haqq. How did Ibn Daghina know what Hazrat Khadija had spoken about Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? People talk about obedience to Rasulullah, following Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Abu Bakr was at a level where he wasn't just obedient to Rasulullah. He was so fanafir Rasul, so lost in the personality of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Not only was his behavior, his conversation, his conduct and all affairs a reflection of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Abu Bakr used to think exactly the same way Rasulullah used to think. Many years later, when Rasulullah came to perform Umrah after he'd seen the dream, Allah has mentioned this in Quran, لَقَدْ صَدَقَ اللَّهُ رَسُولَهُ الرُّؤْيَا بِالْحَقِّ. Rasulullah became ready, 1400 Sahaba became ready with Rasulullah to perform Umrah. Inhabitants of Makkah, the Quraysh intervened, stopped them from entering Makkah at Hudaybiyah. There was extensive dialogue. Treaty was eventually signed. Hazrat Abu Bakr came to Rasulullah, Hazrat Umar came to Rasulullah and said, Ya Rasulullah, are we not on haqq that we are having to agree to this treaty under unfavorable conditions? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Inni Rasulullah, lastu asihi, huwa nasiri. Rasulullah said three things, three phrases. I am Allah's messenger. I don't disobey Allah. He is my helper. Hazrat Umar had no option. He came to Abu Bakr. Abu Bakr, are we not on haqq? Hazrat Abu Bakr did not know what answer Rasulullah had given to Umar. When Umar said, are we not on haqq? Yes, we are on haqq. So what's this treaty? Why? Hazrat Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, without having any knowledge of what had happened between him and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said something. He said, Innahu Rasulullah. Exactly the same thing Rasulullah had said to Umar, Abu Bakr said to Umar radiallahu anhu. Innahu Rasulullah, laysa yasi rabbahu, huwa nasiruhu. He said, he is Rasulullah. He could have said, Nabiyallah, Rasulullah, same word spoken by Rasulullah. Rasulullah said, lastu asihi. Rasulullah could have said this in a different way. But the words of Rasulullah said, Abu Bakr said exactly the same words as Rasulullah spoke. Hazrat Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala could have said, Allah will help him. He didn't say, Allah will help him. Allah madad karega. Nahi, Hazur ne farmaya, Allah mera madadgar hai. Huwa nasiri. Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu said exactly the same thing. Huwa nasiruhu. He didn't say, Allah will help him. Rasulullah said, Allah is my helper. Abu Bakr said, Allah is his helper. Not that Allah will help him. So much. Exactly what used to come out of the noble tongue of Rasulullah. What would be in the noble heart of Rasulullah. What would be in the noble thoughts of Rasulullah would flow down into even the thoughts of Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu.
Narae Takbir.
Allah has made mention of Rasulullah in Quran. Allah said, لَقَدْ جَاءَكُمْ رَسُولٌ مِّنْ أَنفُسِكُمْ عَزِيزٌ عَلَيْهِ مَا أَنِتُمْ حَرِيصٌ عَلَيْكُمْ بِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ رَؤُوفٌ رَّحِيمٌ. Allah chose these two words to describe Rasulullah's personality, رَؤُوفُ الرَّحِيمُ. Rauf, they have similar meanings, a very subtle difference, kind, merciful. Allah said to Rasulullah, you are رَؤُوفُ الرَّحِيمُ. Rasulullah said about Abu Bakr, Arhamu ummati bi ummati. The man most merciful to my ummah is Abu Bakr. In another narration, in another version of the same narration, not just Arhamu ummati, Arafu bi ummati. The man most kind to my ummah is Abu Bakr. Allah said to Rasulullah, Raufur Rahim. Rasulullah said about Abu Bakr, Arham bi ummati. The man most merciful towards my ummah is Abu Bakr. And incidentally, in another hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam has spoken about elders and youngsters. Rasulullah said, "Man lam yarham saghirana وَلَمْ يُوَقِّرْ كَبِيرَنَا فَلَيْسَ مِنَّا. In every community, some are elders, some are young ones. So the elders show mercy to the young and the young show respect to the elders. Mercy is whose duty?
Elders.
Elders show mercy, the young show respect. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, this is why we say Allah isn't just Rahim, Allah is Arhamur Rahimeen, the most merciful of the merciful. Why? Because He is the greatest. There's no one greater than Allah. So no one more merciful than Allah. But when He comes to the ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Rasulullah said, Arhamu bi ummati. Arhamu ummati bi ummati. The man most merciful towards my ummah is Abu Bakr. So it shows the greatest man in this ummah is Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu. There's another great man in this ummah. Everybody came themselves. When Rasulullah started preaching, Hazrat Abu Bakr, he was waiting for Rasulullah to say, I am Rasulullah, so that Abu Bakr could say, Ya Rasulullah, I believe. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam himself said, everybody I presented Islam to hesitated, except Abu Bakr. Moment Rasulullah presented Islam, the same very moment Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu accepted. But Abu Bakr accepted willingly. Hazrat Khadija accepted willingly. Hazrat Usman came willingly. There was one man Rasulullah wanted so desperately. He would pray to Allah, Ya Allah, Allahumma a'izzal Islam, Ya Allah, honor Islam with Amr bin Hisham or Umar ibn al-Khattab. Rasulullah's wish, many of you probably heard many scholars, khatibs, they say, baki sare hazur ke murid hain. Bhi hazur ka murid hona koi mamooli baat hai. Many people pride in being murids of different shuyukh, mashallah, all with due respect. Lekin jo hazur ke murid hon, those who are murids of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, there is simply no comparison. Sare sahaba hazur ke murid, aur hazur ki murad Hazrat Umar. When Hazrat Umar accepted Islam, Jibreel came down. Ya Rasulullah, are you happy at the Islam of Umar? Rasulullah said, yes. Jibreel said, Ya Rasulullah, all the angels are happy as well. All the angels are happy as well. Rasulullah said, Wallahu ja'ala al-haqqa ala lisani Umara wa qalbi. Allah has put haqq on the tongue and heart of Umar. لَقَدْ كَانَ فِي مَا قَبْلَكُمْ مِنَ الْأُمَمِ مُحَدَّثُونَ فَإِنْ يَكُنْ أَحَدٌ فِي أُمَّتِي فَإِنَّهُ عُمَرٌ. There were people before in the nations Allah used to talk to. Allah used to inspire, put in their hearts what Allah liked. And if there is any such man in my ummah, then it is Umar radiallahu anhu. Imam Bukhari again has reported an incident. When Hazrat Umar, there are more than 20 places in the Quran, Hazrat Umar said something, Allah liked it so much, Allah turned it into Quran. Umar radiallahu anhu is Umar. There was an incident when Hazrat Abu Bakr and Hazrat Umar had a bit of an argument. Hazrat Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu said something in haste to Hazrat Umar, which Hazrat Umar didn't like. And Hazrat Abu Bakr immediately realized that he's upset Umar. So Hazrat Abu Bakr said, Umar, forgive me. But Hazrat Umar was Umar. He said, I won't. So Hazrat Abu Bakr left. He came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he said, Ya Rasulullah, kana baini wa bain al-ibn al-Khattab shay. There was an incident between me and the son of Khattab. And I said something to him in haste. And then I sought his forgiveness and he didn't forgive me. Rasulullah said, Yaghfir Allahu lak. Abu Bakr, Yaghfir Allahu lak. Yaghfir Allahu lak. Yaghfir Allahu lak. He didn't forgive you, but I, Rasulullah, say, Ya Allah, forgive him. May Allah forgive you. May Allah forgive you. May Allah forgive you. Hazrat Umar realized Abu Bakr was apologizing. I should have accepted his apology. So Hazrat Umar followed him, went to his house. Where is Abu Bakr? Not home. So Hazrat Umar realized he must have gone to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So Hazrat Umar followed and came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When Hazrat Abu Bakr saw Umar coming, Hazrat Abu Bakr, Imam Bukhari says, got on his knees. Ya Rasulullah, it was my fault. Ya Rasulullah, it was my fault. He knew when, even Abu Bakr knew, when Umar starts talking, then revelation will come in support of who? Umar. Umar was on haqq. Umar is always on haqq. Why shouldn't he be on haqq? When Rasulullah said, Wallahu ja'ala al-haqq ala lisani umara wa qalbi. Allah has put haqq on the tongue and heart of Umar. So the worker saw Umar coming. He got on his knees. Ya Rasulullah, it was my fault. My fault, Ya Rasulullah. Rasulullah saw Umar coming as well. And Rasulullah's noble complexion changed. Rasulullah also knew when Umar talks nothing but haqq. So he saw Umar coming. Rasulullah addressed the people, Oh people, Inna Allah ba'athani ilaykum. Allah sent me to you. Faqultum kadhabt. All of you said, You're a liar. Waqala Abu Bakr sadaqa. It was only Abu Bakr who said he's right. You all rejected me. You all denied me. You all thought I was a liar. It was only Abu Bakr who said he is right. وَوَاصَانِي بِنَفْسِهِ وَمَالِهِ And then he didn't just leave it to that. He assisted me personally, financially, in every way. فَهَلْ تَارِكُولِي صَاحِبِي هَلْ تَارِكُولِي صَاحِبِي Will you not leave my friend for me? When it came to Abu Bakr, Rasulullah didn't want to hear a second word even from Umar. When even Umar, who speaks nothing but haqq, and Rasulullah doesn't want to hear a second word even from Umar regarding Abu Bakr, who is anybody else to say anything about Abu Bakr? I say, even a shadow is not loyal to its original, like the way Abu Bakr was loyal to Rasulullah. There are days, you know, when it's cloudy, you only get a shadow when there is direct light. On the days when it's cloudy, do you have a shadow? There is no shadow on a cloudy day because there is no direct light. You can probably see some shadow because there's direct light. So when there is no direct light, even the shadow abandons you. But Abu Bakr never abandoned Rasulullah, whatever came his way. Somebody said, why do we follow? We love everyone. We love all the companions. Some people love only Hazrat Ali. He said, why do we love Hazrat Ali? Because he never abandoned Rasulullah, never turned his back to Rasulullah throughout his life. Had he ever abandoned Rasulullah, we would have abandoned him as well. I said, well, Qurban jaye. Hazrat Ali ne to zindagi bhar Hazur ka saath nahi choda. Qurban jaye Abu Bakr aur Umar par marne ke baad bhi saath nahi choda. They didn't abandon Rasulullah even after their death. They are with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But Abu Bakr is Abu Bakr. Abu Bakr is Abu Bakr radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. May Allah grant us his love. People nowadays, they think it's their right. They can criticize. Nowadays in colleges, universities, they teach critical analysis. Everybody looks at everything in a critical way. Some people think it's their right to criticize people. Freedom of speech. But as Muslims, people, there is a whole group. One group of people no Muslim dares speak of in any other way but with goodness, and that is the Mubarak Jamaat of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And in that Mubarak Jamaat, no one stands as tall as Umar radiallahu anhu and Hazrat Abu Bakr. But when Rasulullah wasn't prepared even to listen to Umar radiallahu anhu when he came to Abu Bakr, who is anybody else? May Allah have mercy upon us.